trust in God. Oh, set my heart coming from the Lord. Trust in God. Yeah, no matter what it looks like, no matter what it sounds like, no matter how deep the pain, keep doing the Lord's will. In spirit and truth, yeah, there's a blessing waiting for you. It's lonely sometime. I know it's hard sometime. Hallelujah. But you've got to trust the Lord. You've got to trust Him. Somebody for you. Stay in the glory of God. Stay in the place that He has you. And I don't mean the physical place, the spiritual place. This is time for elevation. Not even serving in spirit and in truth. You have people that see your anointing, see your gifts. And some of you, they're jealous of your gifts. Some of you, they're jealous of your anointing. Some of them are praying against you. To your aid. He that have an ear, hear what the prophet is saying. As long as you're in that Jezebel spirit. See, Jezebel is the whore of the Bible. That harlot coming to separate the people of God. Separate the church from the groom, the bride from the groom, with her subtle ways, her adulterous ways, with her adulterous doctrines. Her doctrines are adulterous, taking away the true people of the Most High, away with disguised religion, phoniness, and paganism. No matter how much you tell them, they keep going right back into it. Why? Because the pastors are not teaching the truth in some of these places. Jeremiah 23 tells a very destructive message to the pastors that are leading the flock astray. See, this here now is the new year. It's the new year now. March and April. It's not January. Not in the dead of winter. You don't see the flowers blooming and the bees going around. You don't see the grass turning green. It's still snow. But they're lying to you. Look in Exodus, the 12th chapter, and Exodus, the 13th chapter, the month of Abib, A-B-I-B, or the month of Nisan, or Nisan. That means the first of the year, and it's March, April. But they call it April Fools. They want you to think a rabbit can lay an egg. You say you know the truth, you still go back into it. So many fall into this Jezebel spirit, just like Christmas. Jeremiah, the 10th chapter. The 10th chapter, Jeremiah says, don't get the tree and deck it with gold and silver. But they still go deck the halls with boughs of ivy, la la la, thinking it's all fun and games. He said, learn not the way of the heathen. Jacob, I love. Esau, I hate him. Jacob is Israel, according to the Bible. His name was changed to Israel as he wrestled with the angel. Jacob went on, or Israel went on, to have 12 sons. Those are the 12 children of Israel, 12 tribes of Israel. They broke the laws, the statutes and commandments of God in Deuteronomy 28, and was kicked out of the land of Israel and spread all over the four corners of the earth. But in James 1:1, he's still reaching out to the 12 tribes scattered. And the Old Testament prophets talk about how we're going to be taken back into the land of Israel. See, Israel is a person. He will not always leave us nor forsake us. He said he will call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people. That's a possession word. His. Just like if my people will humble themselves. My people. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. See, when it says, it confuses a lot of people. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. He's not talking about the whole world. He's talking about the world of Israel. The true Israel. It's in Hebrews chapter 1 and Hebrews chapter 11, you'll see the word worlds with an S. Because there's many worlds. And the word worlds, when you civilization or society of people. It doesn't mean just a globe. Oh my God, I wish the pastors would teach. I'm sorry, I just want to play this little song. I haven't done it in a while with the Lord. Let me by the Holy Ghost to prophesy as I play. See, in the fivefold church, it happens all the time. The fivefold church, not you watered down people. There's no shade and no hate. But you gotta come up higher. Start working in your gifts and stop acting like you're working in your gifts just because you dance and learned a couple tongues. Just saying them same old tongues. Eli Bosha, we all heard that before. It's time for you to come into your lineage truth, your lineage truth. Into the work of the Savior, because he's soon to come. I've been walking this road alone, it's alright. I've seen many people walk away. It hurts deep down, it's vexing. But the Bible says, don't grieve the spirit of your minister. For he watches for your soul, and it's not profitable for you if you grieve the minister, because he does not exercise the sword or the wrath of God, the sword, the spirit, in vain. But I love everybody. It's a lonely walk. Gonna often be misunderstood, misinterpreted, even though you lay down your life for people like Jesus did, but not to that great magnitude. This is knowing him in the fellowship of his sufferings. That pain. John 6 and 66, the disciples turned away and walked away from him. It's hurtful knowing him in the fellowship of his sufferings. I'll press on, Lord, I'll press on. Some people know the truth superficially. The outside of historically, but it ain't on the inside. They're not born and bred to die for this gospel. They're still dancing around and playing around with Jezebel. We gotta go forward. Lot had to go forward when his wife turned back. A lot of people got that little red riding hood spirit, as I often say. They see the wolf. They still say, well, Grandma, what big eyes you have. Yeah, it's funny. That's why I bring it up. They still go for the cookies. They're still drinking the Kool-Aid. Until that wolf snatches them up. That snake snatches them up. That scorpion snatches them up. That lion, that tiger, that bear snatches them up. And when they get up there and they say, Lord, we prophesied in your name. We laid hands in your name. We cast out devils in your name. And he's going to say, depart from me. I never knew you. You're not the true Israel if you don't know about the 12 names written around the gate of New Jerusalem, the sons of Israel, and the other 12 are the apostles of the Lamb, the 24 elders. If you don't know about that old harlot that keeps coming between the church and God, message yesterday with all kind of distraction, but I went on and dropped it anyway.